the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese. Hi, this is Chinese Pot coming to you from Shanghai, China. I'm Jenny.
Hey there, I'm John. Welcome, intermediate learners.
对啊,
What's the matter, Jenny?
我在打哈欠。打哈欠。
For those of you that can't see, that would be all of you. She's yawning.
对，为什么打哈欠呢？ 因为我是夜猫子。夜猫子。Jenny,
this is so not true.
啊?
All right, so 夜猫子, that means like a night cat.
诶，对，但是在英文里面，你们用另外一种动物。
Right, we say night owl.
啊，猫头鹰。猫头鹰。That
would be owl.
Owl. 对
Okay, but we're talking about night owl. So in Chinese, we say night cat.
夜猫子
All right, so that's fourth tone, first tone, and then neutral tone.
是的,夜猫子 那今天我们的对话呢,就是一个夜猫子的生活
Yeah, so let's find out what this night owl or night cat has done.
好
你怎么老打哈欠?起得太早?
不是,睡得太晚, 4点才睡。
你这个夜猫子又玩通宵, 去酒吧泡妞了吧?
是啊, 和一帮哥们儿一起去的。
哟,挺有意思的。
是挺有意思的, 就是花了很多钱, 有点心疼我的钱包。
有最低消费吗?
没有最低消费。 大家都很开心，又有美女不停地劝酒，所以喝了很多。看你这么没精神，一定又喝醉了。一下子就喝多了。你怎么回家的？他们送你的？没有，大家都喝醉了，我自己打车的，在车上睡着了。司机好不容易才把我叫醒。哎呦，我的头真疼啊。
你呀,从来不懂得控制自己。Okay,
so we kick off this dialogue with a big yawn.
Oh, 打哈欠,打哈欠。Okay,
so that means to yawn.
对。That's
a verb, so
是的。
打 is third tone.
没错。哈欠
is first, fourth, right?
对,打是动词,哈欠是名词。
Okay, 哈欠 is the noun meaning a yawn.
对。
So you hit out a yawn in Chinese.
那为什么会打哈欠呢? 是起得太早吗? 结果不是, 是睡得太晚。
Yeah, let's talk about these two verbs. They're pretty simple, but we want to make sure we get them straight. So if you get up early, how do you say that?
起得早。And
if you get up too early,
起得太早。And
if you get up late,
起得晚,或者起得太晚。Alright,
and then if you go to sleep late.
哦,那是睡得晚,或者睡得太晚。And
if you go to sleep early.
睡得早,睡得太早。Okay,
so one thing that can be confusing, especially for Chinese people learning English, is if you say sleep late, then they think it means go to sleep late.
对,我们以为是睡得太晚。
Yeah, but sleep late in English actually means in Chinese
起得晚,
right. So you're getting up late. So make sure you get that straight. Don't confuse yourself or the Chinese people by mixing these verbs and adjectives in the wrong way.
所以自己回家要多练习一下啊。好，那我们再看看啊，如果你一个晚上都在玩，那叫玩通宵，玩通宵。
Okay, so that's two first tones?
对,通宵。
So that means like all night.
是的。
All the way through the night.
对。
So can you only play all night? Are there other things you can do all night?
哦,你可以学习通宵。学习通宵。
Yeah, not likely.
哈,以前上学的时候会。Yeah,很久很久以前。或者工作通宵。工作通宵。So
work all night long.
对。 啊,或者你可以去通宵去泡妞,泡妞。
All right, all night long. All right, so let's look at this verb, 泡妞。So that's fourth tone and first tone.
对。
And literally it means like hit on girls.
是的。
This is kind of a slangy word, isn't it?
没错。而且这个不是特别的 refined, 不是特别的 sophisticated.
Yeah, it's something like hit on chicks.
对。
It's not...
不是很 respectful 啊。
Yeah, don't use this when you're talking to, you know, Hu Jintao or something.
对。
It wouldn't come across very well.
嗯。
So, 妞 means girl, right?
没错。
But it's not a very polite word for girl.
不是不是。
And 泡 means what?
泡就是比较 playful, 比较 casual 的一个动词。
All right, but it's hard to say exactly what it means.
没错。泡妞，泡妞。
All right, hit on girls, hit on chicks.
嗯，这个泡呢，好像就是你在做事情没有什么目的，比如说泡酒吧。
Ah, so that's the same word that means like to go to a bunch of bars.
对。
泡酒吧。
泡酒吧就是在玩，然后不是很认真。
All right, so you're not very serious, you're just having a good time.
是的,泡妞,泡酒吧。
Okay, 泡 is the verb there.
嗯,好,那这样你会不会和一帮哥们儿去泡酒吧?一帮哥们儿。
Sometimes I will.
嗯。
So yeah, let's look at that. 哥们儿,what is this word?
就是男性的好朋友。
This is a word that's used more in the north, right?
对。
When I first learned it, I learned that it means something like dude, or like man.
差不多，对对对。
It's very slangy.
没错。
It's what guys use for each other.
对。
So a bunch of guys, they're friends, they call each other 哥们儿。
哥们儿，有点像 buddies, 对吧？
Yeah, buddies.
哥们儿。
So if it's a group of them, then we say...
一帮哥们儿。
So this word 帮 is the same one that means like to help somebody, right?
对，是同一个字，但是意思不一样。
All right, yeah, so this is not the verb that means to help. It's a measure word.
量词。
Yeah, and it just means a group.
对, right? A bunch of, 这样。一帮。
Isn't this the word used in the Gang of Four?
没错。What? 四人帮。
Okay, so in Chinese, it's like the group of four.
对。
Could be a gang, huh?
是的,是的。
So a gang of dudes, gang of buddies.
一帮哥们儿。好。
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to...Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now.To register for your access to over 4,000 lessons, get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
那出去玩的话呢，会花很多钱，所以就要心疼钱包，心疼钱包。
Okay, so 心疼 literally that means your heart aches.
对啊，花了那么多的钱，心都疼了。
So it just means you're very reluctant to part with that money.
没错。
So you can use this for other things as well?
对,比如说我喜欢的一个东西掉了或者坏了,你可以说啊,我真心疼,真心疼。
Like your favorite mug was broken.
对,好,那这样中国很多酒吧都有最低消费,最低消费,对吧?
Okay, so literally this means like the lowest...fee or the lowest purchase.
对。
Something like that?
是的。消费这里的意思就是消费的钱, the amount you 消费。
Consume, right?
对对对。
So there's like a minimum consumption. In other words, you have to buy stuff at the bar. You can't just go and hang out.
没错,这个叫 cover charge, 是吧?最低消费。
Cover charge is a little different.
Oh.
Because cover charge is you get in the door.You have to pay.
Oh.
But 最低消费 is you come in,
对
you're in for free, but you got to buy something.
没错没错。
So it's just where they make you pay.
是的。最低消费。好，接下来我们再看一个劝酒。劝酒。
Yeah, this character might be a little unfamiliar. Okay, so 劝 by itself means to urge
对
someone to do something, right?
没错。
So usually you like 劝 someone to do something.
对。
But in this case, it's not a verb, it's... urging someone to alcohol.
酒，但是这儿呢，就是喝酒的意思，劝别人喝酒。
So in other words, you're getting them to drink.
对。
You're urging them strongly to drink.
是的。
Peer pressure.
这个叫劝酒。那很多人会不停地劝酒，不停地劝酒。
So 不停地 means like without stopping or unceasingly.
真恐怖。
Jenny's worst nightmare here.
对，不停地劝酒。那这样的话呢，就又喝醉了，又喝醉了。
All right, so we probably know 喝醉 means to get drunk.
对。
So 又喝醉了 means you're drunk again.
是啊，又发生了。以前喝醉过，这次又喝醉了。
Yeah, so from this statement, we get the idea that this friend often gets drunk.
没错。然后这些人的 excuse 经常是一下子就喝多了，一下子就喝多了。
Yeah, so like 一下子 is like all at once.
是的。
Like it happened so fast.
对对对。
The girls were getting me to drink and I just had, you know, five glasses and all of a sudden I was drunk.
对、
right?
美女劝酒然后我也不知道一下子就喝多了啊一下子就是非常快这个意思。
So the person got drunk and they ended up in a taxi, right?
对。
And what happened when they arrived at their place?
在车上睡着了司机好不容易。才把我叫醒，好不容易才把我叫醒。
Alright, so if we ignore the 好不容易才，what do we get?
司机把我叫醒。
So that means the driver woke me up.
对。
So he took me and he woke me up.
是的，就是把人叫醒。那么这个非常不容易哦，因为喝醉了，所以就是好不容易才把我叫醒。
So, 好不容易 means very not easy.
对。
So, it's very difficult. So, he had to go through a lot of difficulty.
才。
And only then
对
could he wake him up.
是的。所以才是一个连接。
Yeah, so this emphasizes that it was not easy to wake him up.
好不容易才把我叫醒。这样今天最后的一个词是懂得。懂得。你从来不懂得控制自己。
Okay, so 懂得, this is the same 懂 as just to understand.
对。
So we add this 得, and what does it change?
意思一样,和懂的意思一样。
Okay, so if you say 懂, you can also say 懂得。
是的。
When you're talking about understanding something or knowing how
对, knowing
to do something.
没错。你可以说从来不懂控制自己。或者从来不懂得控制自己。
Okay, now we're about to listen to the dialogue one more time. And this time I want you guys to listen for sentences ending with 的。
的。
And we're about to talk about why do some of these sentences end with 的, what's going on there. So let's listen again.
仔细听一下。
你怎么老打哈欠?起得太早?
不是，睡得太晚，四点才睡。
你这个夜猫子又玩通宵，去酒吧泡妞了吧？
是啊，和一帮哥们儿一起去的。
哟，挺有意思的。
是挺有意思的，就是花了很多钱，有点心疼我的钱包。
有最低消费吗？
没有最低消费，大家都很开心，又有美女不停地劝酒。所以喝了很多，
看你这么没精神，一定又喝醉了。
一下子就喝多了。
你怎么回家的？他们送你的？
没有，大家都喝醉了，我自己打车的，在车上睡着了，司机好不容易才把我叫醒。哎呦，我的头真疼啊！
你呀，从来不懂得控制自己。
Okay, we're back. And as promised, we're going to examine some sentences that end in 的.
是的。
And talk about what's going on there.
是的,你看。
是的。All right, so Jenny, can you read those individual sentences for us?
好。第一句是和一帮哥们儿一起去的。和一帮哥们儿一起去的。然后又有你怎么回家的?他们送你的。你怎么回家的?他们送你的。那最后一句呢是我自己打车的我自己打车的
Okay, now before Jenny explains what's going on here, I should mention that these are part of the 是的 pattern.
哎，对。
And if you study Chinese grammar, you're familiar with this, and it's usually used to like affirm the events that took place.
对。
Now in this case, we're talking about a story that happened in the past.
哎。
So Jenny, what's going on here?
那这里的的就是表明这件事情是发生在过去。
Okay, so this helps make it clear that these things happened in the past.
没错，比如说，如果我们不用的，你说和哥们儿一起去，或者你怎么回家？这个听起来好像你在问别人你现在想怎么回家，或者我现在想和哥们儿一起去，就是没有那么清楚，你说的是一件过去的事情。
Right, so if you don't have the in those examples, it sounds like you could be talking about the present or the future.
对。
But if you're asking about the past or telling about the past,
是的。
Using this 是的 pattern makes it clear that it happened in the past.
对，非常非常的清楚。
Even if there's no 是 there, because you'll notice that the 是 is missing at the front.
是的。
Alright, anyway, if you have questions about that pattern, leave them in the comments of the lesson on ChinesePod.com and we can explain it further.
好，那今天我们的课就到这里。夜猫子，赶快睡觉吧。我们下次再见。
再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.ChinesePod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number
0734.
So just go to www.ChinesePod.com/0734 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.ChinesePod.com/0734.